Okay, it's March 15th, 2014, the Ides of March, and I got my heirloom seeds in here in this packet. It comes in a box like this right here, and I ordered it Tuesday night. Wednesday at lunchtime, they said that it had shipped, and today's Saturday, so 3 days. And I've got squash golden zucchini, squash black beauty zucchini. See, these are heirloom names, so it's not just zucchini, you know. Okay, for peas, we got green, oh, where's that? I'm zooming in too much here. Green arrow peas. Black eyed peas is black eyed peas. Then, got bean pole, purple potted, or bean, purple potted pole, purple hull peas, beans. Now the tomatoes are the thing. This is, we've got like about five other tomatoes from last year and the year before and the year before that. But I ordered some different ones this year because there's so many varieties. This is Super Sioux tomatoes. And look at the seeds inside those fruit right there. Every one of those can be dried out and grown next year. You know, and this, that's the thing about heirloom seeds. You can grow this stuff forever. Then you've got Castelluto Genovese. Oops, I'm sorry, I thought I was on camera. Tomatoes. Those are the big plump ones, like. Not like the marigolds or the, there's another one, I can't remember, that's real plump. But like I said, these are nice heirloom juicy. One of these tomatoes would be equal to about 10 to 15 other tomatoes you'd buy in the store as far as nutrition. Probably more than that even. More of the other tomatoes to equal one of these tomatoes. Yeah, Brandywine tomatoes. Heirloom Solutions is the company, by the way. You want to get online and check that out. They've got so much. And then we've got Amish paste. You know, again, I just look at the seeds inside that fruit and I'm thinking, you know, we might take like 10 of these tomatoes, if that, and grab the seeds out of that for next year. And it's just like I said, we got seeds from last year and the year before. And like I said, it's fine. And I grow a little bit of that, but I get the new ones too. And there's your California Wonder Pepper, which is basically your bell pepper. Those did really well last year. But I'm going to put a whole lot more out this year in the garden. The whole front row is going to be nothing but peppers all the way across. Plus by the house, we'll have about six. And I've got orange peppers, plant, orange bell. And they go from 50 seeds. This one here has got 100 seeds. That's the orange bell. These tomato seeds. I got more seeds yet. The tomato seeds, they have 100 seeds. There's some that have 250 seeds. But like I say, right now, just to get this on here, I've got the ghost pepper. See, now these are in paper. If you look inside the envelope there, they're inside pepper. These are hot peppers. So touching these, very careful. You want to wear gloves, like latex gloves and such, and then wash your hands afterwards too. Now, there shouldn't be, but well, how many of these? This is not very many. This one, I don't think. It doesn't say. But this one might be like 30 seeds or something like that. But like I said, they produce, and then the seeds you get out of a pepper, it's just astronomical how many more you'll get. And you got your Beaver Dam pepper, which are those thick peppers you get with pizza sometimes. They'll give you a thick peppers. You get 100 seeds of that one. See, so. Give you basic instructions on the back. I got flowers too. We have hummingbirds around here, so these are excellent for hummingbirds, this particular flower. You know, and I think there's 100 seeds of that one. If I'm blurred or off the camera screen, it's because I'm trying to read it off the camera. Now we have these sunflower torch. 50 seeds of this one. A mixture for hummingbirds and other insects. But I've got some marigolds too. Help keep some pests away from the garden. This is called 4 o'clock. I see the picture of them right there. To go around the porch. I might put some around the garden too. I don't know. I can't read it. 50 seeds of this one. And here's the marigolds. Look at these seeds, man. These are going to go around the porch and around the garden too. Like I say it helps get away certain critters and insects. This one here has got 250 seeds of this one. If I can find it right there. Like I say, it'll go from 50 to 250 seeds per pack. You can order 1,000 and such, but I think you probably get like 2 packs or 3 packs, whatever. Anyway, this is artichokes, which are more difficult, I think, to grow, but we're going to try them. And this one's got 250 seeds of this one. Artichokes. And then we got the red okra, burgundy okra. Oh, this is some delicious okra. It's reddish color. Oh, man. I like that better than the green. I grew up on green okra down here. It's beautiful. But most people don't like that. Then we've got some spinach, which is great for salads. Oh, we got, how many seeds is this? 500 seeds. 500 seeds of this Bloomsdale spinach. Okay. And last but not least, I have some butter beans. I thought I had some black eyed peas. I might have already done them. Or I might have put them on. Yeah, I did black eyed peas. Then I've got this Henderson lima bean. You know, it's kind of like a butter bean, but I like it. 100 seeds. Where is that? Right there. There are certain ways with ones that don't put off a seed for the plant that you can use a flower from it. I don't exactly know what I'll have to study on that. But here's my invoice to come with it. Shows me the list of what I ordered. I ordered it on Tuesday, Wednesday it was shipped, and today's Saturday I got it. So, Heirloom Solutions. That's where I bought my generator from. And like I said, it's a great company. A guy named Tim works there. He's helped me in the past because, I mean, I get confused on their site. I said, boy, I feel dumb. But, you know, he's really good and gracious. He emailed me and gave me the information on how to do it. I got the stuff taken care of Tuesday night. And like I said, Wednesday, it was already shipped. And then I got it today, Saturday. So, that garden over here is 40 feet by 40 feet. I've said 14 by 14. I meant 40 by 40. Get over here. Okay. 40 feet across by 40 feet. 40 across by length, whatever. 40 by 40. It's a 40 foot square. And then I'm going to burn that branch over there and then just spread that stuff across. It won't hurt it. It won't be as beneficial as I was wanting it, but it's breezy right now. It's nice outside. It's supposed to rain this evening or tomorrow and then tomorrow night. And we're going to get a wintry mix. You know, it's going to be like, down to 38. So it's basically rain. And everybody needs to get their bread and milk because, you know, it'll be a day and then you'll be able to get out again. But the garden will go in. It's going to go north to south, the rows this year, instead of east to west like I have the last few years. And they don't seem to be doing that well. I thought they would with this because my sun rises in the east, comes right over, and sets in the west. So I figured that'd be great. But like I said, they didn't come out as good as I was hoping. Plus, my knees were giving me a lot of problems. And then, you know, a lot of major, major personal things happened with my mom passing and everything. And so anyway, this year the garden should look very nice. Those are onions too, by the way, we got from a lady we worked with. And I planted them over there. They're growing. So, you know, you just keep trimming them and you keep using them. So I have to try to work around that a little bit. I plant some other stuff over there too. Dig up on each side of it and almost all the way up to it. And then plant stuff. There you go.